Now that we've created our Hello API view, we need to map a URL to this view so we can access it via the HTTP server. The way that you map URLs to views in Django is you use something called the URL dispatcher. The URLs are described in the file called urls.py. Currently, if you open up our profiles project and you look at urls.py, you'll see the existing URL configuration for the site. Notice here that you have the admin site mapped to admin site.urls. This is for the Django admin site, which we accessed earlier in Chrome using the /admin URL. This URL file config tells Django to forward anything with the admin /, to the admin app. We need to create our own mapping to our profiles API app. We're going to call the URL /API. So start by including the include function at the top of our urls.py file. It's best practice to keep a urls.py file for each Python project that you add to the app. So we're going to create a urls.py project here, and we're going to include it from the root project's urls.py file. For that, we need to import the include function. So type from django.conf.urls import include. Okay, so now we need to add a URL to this URL patterns list. Start by typing URL and then R and then create a new string and start the string with this caret symbol and type API /, and then comma, and then we want to use the include function and pass a string that says profiles api.urls. Let me just explain what this does. You describe Django URLs using a technology called regular expressions. Regular expressions is a way to manipulate strings so that you can detect certain string patterns and extract certain data from a string. It can get quite complicated, but you don't need to know it in too much detail in order to make basic Django URLs. I'll explain what this regular expression does. So the R indicates that this string is a regular expression. The caret at the beginning of the URL says we want to ensure that the beginning of the string starts with API /. So anything that starts with API /, is going to get matched and passed through to this profiles api.urls file. If you want to learn more about Django URLs, I've included a link in the resources of this video to the Django URL dispatcher documentation. You can head over to that if you want to learn Django URLs in more detail. So we include the profiles api.urls file, but we haven't created that file yet. So the next step is to create this URLs file in our profiles API project. So save this URLs file and right click on the profiles API and click new file. Call the file urls.py, hit enter. And now we're creating a brand new file. We're gonna start by including the URL function. So from django.conf.urls import URL. And we're also gonna import our views. So the views.py file that we modified and added our API view to earlier. So type from dot import views. So again, the dot means import from the root location and import our views module. Now we can describe our URLs pattern. So type URL patterns equals and create a new list object. And we're only going to add one item to the list, and we're going to describe it as a URL. So that calls this URL function here. And again, we're going to start, we're going to type R for regular expression, and we're going to write our regular expression for our URL. So we want to create a URL called hello view that's going to map to our API view. So use the caret and type hello hyphen view forward slash. Now after the string, put a comma, and we need to tell Django which view we want to run at this URL. So we want to call our hello API view. So we're going to type views.hello API view. And we want to return this view as a view object. So type dot as underscore view. And it's a function. So you need to put these two empty brackets here. And you can end the line in a comma. Okay, so save that file. And this is our URL's pattern. So I'll just explain what's going to happen when we call our API view. When we call our API view, it's going to look at the root project URL's config. It's going to detect that we have API at the beginning of our URL, and it's going to look inside the profiles API.urls module. That's here, profiles API.urls module. It's then going to check the next part of the URL after the slash API part, and it's going to see that we typed hello view. And then it's going to render this, the result of this views API view. And it's going to return that result to the screen. Okay, so that's how you create URLs in Django. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next lesson.